Hi, my name's Alan Housley, and I'm going to be spending a few minutes with you to show you how to download new software. We're going to present all the steps here, some of which you may know, and feel free to fast forward or skip those steps. But what we'll show here is how to configure the LM200 for Bluetooth operation, connecting the Bluetooth transceiver to the PC with the cabling, determining the COM port that you've connected the Bluetooth transceiver to, enabling the Loadman Fleet Manager for what is known as Terminal Connect to the LM200, and finally doing the actual download of the new software to the LM200 meter. So to begin with, you need to configure the LM200 for Bluetooth operation. Go to that meter, go into Setup and Configuration, and find installation mode, install. In there, go to Setup RS-232, and on port number 1, turn Bluetooth on. And then exit the Setup and Configuration. Next thing is you need to prepare the transceiver and the cables for connecting to your PC. We've supplied a Perini SD1000 Bluetooth transceiver that has an antenna and a power cable. Plug the power cable into the side of the transceiver. There's a small port for the power cable. And then the USB connector, which we're showing right here, plug that into an available USB port, and that's to power this Bluetooth transceiver. And then you need to obtain an RS-232 cable that we're showing here, this blue cable. This is a male DB9 male connector at one end, and at the other end is a USB. Connect the RS-232 cable to the transceiver and then plug the USB end of the cable into an available COM port on your PC. So now you have the cabling set up on the PC for communicating to the LM200 meter that's set up with Bluetooth. So now this next video portion is going to demonstrate the steps for setting up Loadman Fleet Manager software, which is used as a platform for connecting to the LM200. Okay, this demonstration is to help guide you through setting up your PC, your Loadman Fleet Management software for connection to the LM200 in a terminal connect mode. And this terminal connect mode allows you to download programs to the LM200 and to change firmware such as custom headings. So the first thing you do is you need to go down to the start button, because what we have to do is find out what COM port you plugged in the Bluetooth transceiver. So you go up to computer, and this is a Windows 7 machine, and it's very similar to a Windows XP machine. And you right click on computer or my computer, and you come down here and you click on manage, and this is to allow us to manage hardware inside of your PC. This takes a few moments to come up. And what we're going to be doing is coming down here and you click on Device Manager. And what you're looking for are ports and COM ports. Right here, ports. You double click and you can see that we have a prolific USB to serial COM port on COM 3. This could be, depending on where you plugged it in and what USB you plugged it in, it could be COM 1, COM 2, COM 3, and some very powerful computers, they can go clear up to 8 to 10. But mine's sitting on COM 3. Now I can exit out of here, and I'll be using that information in just a bit. So now, you first pull up the Loadman Fleet Management software. And one of the first things you need to check is go up to the Tools and scroll down to Advanced Settings And what you see is that I have Bluetooth meter connections turned on. This is counterintuitive, but you need to turn it off. Turn it off, and it tells me I need to restart to be able to totally disable this Bluetooth connection, but I'm disabling it for load man fleet management use, because we're going to be in a terminal emulation mode. So you go over here to database, you click on restart, restarts load man, and we now have fully disabled the Bluetooth from the fleet management software, but it is available to us for this terminal connect. So now I go up to tools. I scroll down to advanced functions, excuse me, I scroll down to connections, because the very first thing we got to do is see if we have COM3 even defined in our Loadman Fleet Management software. Click on connections, and I look at, I have a Bluetooth connection, I've got TCP, I've got a COM4 and a COM5 and several other things, but I don't have a COM3, so I click on add. So this is where you name the port, so I'm going to call it COM3. It's going to be set at 9600 baud to be at the same baud rate as the LM200, and I sometimes just like to put USB, just to remind myself this is one of the USB COM ports. Right now the baud rate's set to 2400, and so you click on 9600. It's showing COM1 as a COM port, but I'm going to check COM3, and you may even need to enter a COM number here if you're not defining COM1 through COM4. Stop bits, all of these are the default. One stop bit, three connect attempts, one connect timeout, 1 second timeout, data attempts 30, data timeout 1, and we say OK. Now we turn to this screen and you see that we do have COM3 is now set up at 9600 baud with the data attempts and the timeouts that we had set. And let's cancel that out. Okay. So we're all done. Close this. And now what we're going to do is we are going to attempt to make a connection, a terminal connection, to the LM200. Go to the tools, pull down to advanced functions, and click on connect to COM port. Now it's, at this point, ask us which COM port do we want. Remember, it's COM port 3, it's that USB port. Okay. We see a terminal screen coming up here. Now the first thing that I do at this point is I go over to my Bluetooth transceiver, and there's a switch on the side. It should be set to on. I turn it off and on, and when that happens you'll see this OK come up on the screen. I'll do it again. Off and on. And that tells me that we're communicating and we're connected. And at this point I'm ready to connect to the LM200 through the Bluetooth, and we have a button up here to assist you with that. So you click on Bluetooth query, and it's going to search for this Loadman LM200. And there may be some other Bluetooth devices that might even show up here if they're in your area, such as your phone or some type of device on your desktop. But this is the Loadman, the meter. You see Loadman right here. You highlight that and you say connect. And in the background you're watching as a connection is being made between your PC and the LM200 meter. And at this point you hold down the control key, hold it with one hand, and then hold the T, as in the letter T key, hold that until you see the terminal emulation mode screen come up. And now you are connected. And what we're going to do is in this demonstration here, and start a new demonstration for whichever work you're going to be doing with your LM200. Okay, now that we have the LM200 all set up, we have the Loadman Fleet Manager set up, all the cables set up, we're now ready to do the download of the new program to the LN200. Now we're prepared to download the new program to the LN200 meter. And the first thing you need to do is find the program that was emailed to you. In my case, I have two versions here. I have an English version and a metric version. This happens to be version 6.8a, and I'm choosing the English version, and I just drag it out here to my desktop because I'm going to need to access that for download. Get out of email, start up LoadMan, fleet management software, and go up to Tools, and let's go through this sequence again, but you go down in Advanced Settings and make certain that Bluetooth meter connections is turned off. I have it checked, so I need to uncheck it. This message is telling me I need to restart LoadMan fleet management software. Restart. Okay, so Bluetooth should now be disabled, and it's freed up for us to use for a terminal connect. So we go to Advanced Functions, connect COM port. I'm using COM port 3. Click OK. I usually like to go out to my transceiver, turn it on and turn it off, turn it back on and make certain it's connected with this OK here, and Bluetooth query. You see the LoadMan meter has been found. Connect. And I like to press Control M O N Enter, and we're in the monitor mode. Now we're ready to download. Click on Download, and I just happen to be on the desktop. Here's my file. LoadMan underbody version 6.8a, English version. Open. And what you're seeing is the dialog for the download, and this is the download in sequence. You're watching this counter. It's a hexadecimal counter. I'm going to pause here and we'll fast forward to the end. So the download is done. We click OK. We can close out of the Terminal Connect and close out of LoadMan Fleet Manager if you wish. And then we're going to go to the final step for preparing the LM200. Now the final step in the whole process is to first disconnect power from the LM200 meter. If you were to press on any buttons, you're going to see that nothing is activated. That's because there's new software that's been downloaded and it hasn't been fully reset. So disconnect power to the LM200, reconnect the power, turn on the LM200, and as it's coming on, you'll be able to note the new program version at power up, and you're all set to go.